A few months ago, I've made a video about S-Log 3 on the Sony a7S III, the link will be down in the description below, and I had a ton of questions about working with 8-bit cameras like Sony a7 III or A6000 lineup and S-Log 2 workflow, so here is my advice on it. What's good guys, my name is Oleg Nikitin and you're watching No Limits on channel, so let's dive into it. 8-bit colors mean that you have 256 shades of red, green and blue or RGB, and when multiplying all three we get 16 million colors in general. 10-bit instead has 1024 shades per channel of red, green and blue, and in total we get more than a billion of colors. It means that we can heavily color correct, grade or manipulate the image in general before seeing artifacts or color banding, which is a number of lines on a gradient color, like skies or a colorful wall lit by a window. But still, 8-bit is a totally workable bit depth, and I've been working with the 8-bit cameras for more than 10 years now, and I still use my Sony a6300 on a regular basis. S-Log 3 is too flat for 8-bit cameras, unfortunately, and while it is still existent in cameras like Sony a7 III, a7S II and a6300 for instance, in my opinion it is hardly usable. So, to maximize the dynamic range and performance of your 8-bit cameras, we'll be using the S-Log 2. It has around 10 to 11 stops of dynamic range and when graded properly gives you very nice colors. Let's start off by setting your camera. Choose any picture profile and set gamma to S-Log 2, color mode to S-Gamma 3. Cine and detail at -2. You can play around with it, but I prefer not to leave it at -7 because the image appears a little soft to my eye. And that's it, no more tweaks. Then comes exposing and white balance. Exposing log is always the most important part, because when you lower the exposure in post, you push the noise down, and when you raise the exposure in post, you introduce a lot more noise. So, to expose properly, you need to expose as bright as possible without clipping your highlights, like sky for instance. For this, I either use false color tool on my Atomos Ninja 5 or zebras at 95 IRE and expose for the sky, until I see the zebra on it, or I set the zebra at 75 IRE and expose for the skin, till I see the zebra on the skin, and then lower the exposure by a third of a stop. Of course, you should use the lowest ISO possible, for instance on the Sony a6300 it is ISO 800, and also a fast lens, like f2 or lower, when shooting in darker conditions. In my opinion, ISO 6400 on the crop sensor Sony a6300 with proper exposure is totally usable and covers 90% of low light shooting scenarios. This method will provide you with the best noise performance. Also, to properly monitor your picture and exposure, you can use Alistair Chapman's free LUT pack for S-Log 2. The link will be down in the description below, and you can also thank Alistair by sending some money for coffee to him. I prefer using -1.5 EV or -2 EV LUTs, both for monitoring and for grading. Also in this pack you can find -G LUTs. They will reduce the amount of green color because Sony cameras tend to have a green tint. Also, it is important to shoot in the highest resolution and bitrate possible. In case of Sony a6300 or Sony a7S II, it's 4K 100 megabits per second, so you will have more information to work with in post. White balance is also crucial because you have very limited room for color correction and color grading, that is why you need to set proper white balance while shooting. Use RGB parade on your monitor or a gray card with custom white balance tool for that. During editing and grading, I simply apply the same LUT as I was using during my shoot and tweak the image a little bit so I'm satisfied with the result. Make sure not to crash the shadows and not to blow the highlights if possible. Also pay attention to skin tone because it's one of the most important parts of the image for human eyes perception. You can also use a little bit of denoiser in post to reduce the banding effect a little bit. And be careful not to push and pull the image too strong because it starts to show the color artifacts sooner than the 10-bit footage. Be careful with skies and color gradients, the corrections should be very gentle with those. I even use S-Log 2 in low light, you can watch my a7 III versus a7 S3 versus Zcam E2 low light performance test and my video comparison of Sony a6300, a7 S3, a7 S2 and Sony FS7 to see the low light and overall performance in different picture profiles as well. Links will be in the YouTube card and down in the description below. I was always afraid to use Log for many years, but after I understood all the nuances of it and tried shooting with it a lot, I got much better results out of my 8-bit cameras. I hope this video was helpful to you guys. If you have some questions or opinions, do drop a comment below. Also, if you like the content on my channel, you can hit the like and subscribe buttons and the notifications bell to see more of my upcoming videos. Thanks so much for watching, this was Oleg Nikitin, and I see you in the next video. Take care, guys. Bye.